Hello everyone. Today I will demonstrate how to create partitions and APFS volumes on your Samsung SSD T7 using disk utility on a Mac. The process is the same whether you are using a Samsung T5, T7, T9 or another brand of SSD or hard disk drive. In this tutorial, I will use a MacBook Pro M1 running macOS Sonoma. To start, connect your Samsung SSD T7 to your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac, or Mac Mini using the provided cable. If you can see the icon for your T7 SSD on your desktop, navigate to the Finder menu. If the Finder menu is not visible, click on the desktop or your screen to make it visible in the menu bar. And then select Settings in macOS Ventura or Sonoma or Preferences in older versions of macOS. In the Settings or Preferences window, click the General tab and ensure the external disks checkbox is ticked. After following these steps, you should see the icon for your Samsung SSD or other hard disk drives on your desktop. Before creating partitions or volumes on your internal or external SSD, make sure to backup your important files to prevent data loss if something goes wrong. If you need to format your drive before creating partitions or adding volumes, watch this tutorial. I will leave the link to the tutorial in the description box of this video. To add a volume or partition to your Samsung SSD T5, T7, or T9, launch the Disk Utility app by clicking the Spotlight search, typing Disk Utility, and pressing Enter on your keyboard. You can also find the Disk Utility application in the Utilities folder inside your Applications folder. If you can see your drive, click the View menu and select Show All Devices. To find your external SSD or hard disk drive in the left-hand sidebar under the External section. This is my internal drive, and this one is the external one. Now you need to decide whether to add a volume or a partition. Even though a volume and a partition are not exactly the same thing, you can use either of them to install different versions of macOS or for backup purposes. However, starting from macOS High Sierra, Apple introduced APFS, Apple File System, which is optimized for flash drives or SSDs and offers better performance and features. If your Mac uses APFS file system, Apple recommends creating volumes instead of partitions. APFS volumes dynamically share the available free space within a container, meaning you don't have to pre-allocate a fixed size for each volume, unlike partitions where space is fixed and might be wasted if not fully utilized. APFS volumes offer more flexibility and efficiency. If you are running an old Mac that uses the HFS Plus file system, also known as macOS Extended Journal, you would need to partition your hard drive to manage different storage areas. Whether you decide to create a partition or a volume, it is important to backup your files. If something goes wrong or you change your mind, you can easily delete your partition or volume and start from scratch, regardless of your choice be sure to back up your files in advance. To find out what file system your Mac uses, right-click or control-click on your hard disk drive. Select Get Info from the menu and check the Format section. In my case, it is APFS. Yours could be the same or macOS Extended Journal, also known as HFS Plus. Since I use a MacBook Pro M1 with an internal SSD using the APFS file system and a Samsung external SSD, it makes sense to create volumes on my external SSD. If your Mac uses the HFS Plus file system, then you need to create partitions. I don't need to create partitions on my external SSD. However, for the purpose of this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to create partitions and then volumes. To create partitions, first select your external disk and click Partition. Next, click the plus button and then click the Add Partition button. In my case, the Disk Utility app automatically divided my SSD into two equally sized partitions. To add one more partition, click the plus button. To remove a partition, select it and then click the minus button. Clicking the revert button will undo any changes you have made during this session and take you back to the initial state. To change the partition size according to your needs, select the partition you want to resize. Then you can drag the small circle on the partition's edge to increase or decrease the size. Or enter the desired size in the size field. To change the name of a partition, click on it and enter a new name, such as Personal Files or Work Files. Select a suitable format from the Format menu. In most cases, this will be APFS, Apple File System, for SSDs and newer macOS versions. If your Mac currently uses an HFS Plus file system, select macOS Extended Journal. If you are having trouble choosing the right format or want more information about different formats, please watch this video. If you need to password protect your external drive, check out this tutorial. I will add the tutorial links in the description box of this video. Click More below the video to expand the description box and access the links, or watch them at the end of this video. Once you are happy with your settings, click Apply. Then Partition. And finally done. Now you can use your partition to back up your work files, personal files, music, photos, and video files. This is the partition for the personal files, and this one is the untitled one.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
As mentioned, I use a MacBook Pro M1 with an internal SSD that uses the APFS file system and a Samsung external T7 SSD. Creating APFS volumes is the best option for me. I plan to clone the content of my MacBook Pro M1 internal disk, including its OS to one volume. This way, if something goes wrong, I can restart or boot my Mac from the external drive and continue with my work. The untitled volume is around 499.74 gigabytes. I will rename it to Mac Clone. Next, I will create another volume to install the macOS beta versions. First, I select the APFS container and click the plus button to add another volume. For the name, I enter macOS beta. I now enter 80 gigabytes for the reserve size, which is the minimum size. This volume can expand if it needs more space, which is an advantage of a volume over a partition, since a partition size cannot be expanded. If you want to prevent a volume size from expanding, enter your preferred size in the quota field, which is the maximum size for the volume. However, you don't need to enter a size. You can leave the size field empty. After that, I click OK. Then click Add to create the second volume. And finally, click Done. You can add one more volume by clicking the APFS container and the plus button. If you click your disk, the volume button won't be available. Next, enter a name for your new volume and a desired size. If the new volume will be less than 1 gigabyte, make sure to select megabyte from the size menu and click OK. I don't need to create another volume, so I click Cancel. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.